Peach Baby. Once upon a time, an old wood gatherer and his wife lived on the bank of a swift-flowing river in Nagano Prefecture in Japan. Mighty pine forests hemmed them in on all sides, and the mountains reared their proud heads up to the sky. Their life was idyllic, except for one thing. They had no children. And although they loved each other dearly, their house lacked the joyous sound of a child's laughter. One morning, at the beginning of May, the old woman went down to the river, carrying her load of laundry on her back, while her husband went off into the woods to gather firewood. The old woman was beating the clothes on a flat stone, listening to the sounds of the forest. The splash, gurgle, swish of the river, the wind sighing in the pine branches, the cree-cree of a solitary pheasant,
cree-cree, cree-cree,
the barking of the farmhouse dogs, and the occasional chattering of monkeys. Suddenly, she heard the sound of something bobbing up and down in the water.
Bloop, 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 bloop.
She looked up and was surprised to see before her a large pink peach. She reached out and managed to grab it.
Oh, I've never seen a peach this big before. How nice it will be to have this for dinner tonight. We haven't had fresh fruit for ages.
So she picked up her washing, tied it on her back again, and carried the fruit home under her arm. That evening, after their meal, which was as simple as usual, she said to her husband,
I've got a special treat for you. Can you guess what it is?
Of course the old man couldn't. So she happily brought out her newfound treasure and placed it in front of him.
Good heavens! Where on earth did you find this? It's enormous!
Floating in the river. Aren't we lucky? Come on, let's have it right away.
The old man pulled out his knife and was about to halve it when, to their great surprise, they heard a little voice which seemed to be coming from inside the peach.
Don't cut me! Please don't cut me!
And just then, the peach split open. There, sitting inside, was a lovely, shiny-faced little boy, no bigger than a sparrow. The old couple were speechless. But the boy began to speak.
I've been sent to you from heaven to bring you happiness in your old age. Please be kind to me.
The old couple raised their eyes to heaven and thanked the gods. They called the boy Momotaro, which means Peach Boy, and they brought him up as their son. 15 years passed, and the boy grew bigger and stronger year by year. He helped his parents in many ways, pulling down branches for the old man, drawing water from the well, rethatching the roof of the cottage, digging their little garden, and carrying the washing down to the river and back. One year, on Boy's Day, they were sitting at dinner eating a peach, which, of course, was their favourite dessert, and discussing the boy's future. Momotaro had been thinking for a while.
My dear parents, you have been so kind to me all these years, but now I feel I must leave you to seek my fortune out in the world. I hope I shall not be away too long, and I am sure that when I return, you will be richer beyond all your dreams.
The old couple were very sad to hear his words, but they realized that the time had come for him to go. The old woman made lots of his favorite rice dumplings and put them in a strong bag for him, saying,
These are not ordinary dumplings, my dear son. They are made to an old and secret recipe and will give the strength of 10 men to whoever eats them.
The old man presented him with a new headband, saying,
"This will help you preserve your strength and keep you out of danger. And please think of us whenever you put it on."
With tears in their eyes, the old couple wished him good luck, said goodbye, and stood at the door of the cottage, watching Momotaro walk down the path towards the deep woods, proudly wearing his new headband and with the bag of dumplings slung over his shoulder. He was soon out of sight, and the old couple went inside, quietly praying that they would live to see his return. Momotaro walked on through woods and fields and through mountain passes until he came in sight of the sea. The sun was glittering on the waves, and in the far distance he could see the silhouette of a mountainous island, black and sinister. He walked down the hill into the village, hoping to find somewhere to rest for the night. But all was silent, and there was not a person to be seen. But suddenly, he heard the sound of a dog barking inside one of the houses. Momotaro slid open the door, and a very thin, hungry-looking animal leapt out at him, growling and snapping. Momotaro was surprised to hear the dog say,
"Get out of my village, or I'll bite you until you can't move."
Momotaro did not move, but instead put his hand into his bag and pulled out one of the rice dumplings.
"Here, eat this. Then you'll feel much better and stronger."
The dog stopped, sniffed at the dumpling, and then began to eat it as fast as it could. Then it licked its lips, sat down, and spoke again.
"Oh, that was very good. Thank you, sir. I do feel a lot stronger now. Please forgive my bad manners when you arrived. You see, several days ago, this was a happy fishing village. But suddenly one morning, a boat full of evil demons came from Ogre Island, the one you can see on the horizon, and frightened away all the villagers. Then they stole everything from the temple treasure house and left me locked up all alone in this house."
Momotaro's eyes shone.
"Ah, this sounds like the start of a real adventure. Now, how can we get to the island to look for the stolen treasure?"
"What? You really want to go there? But those demons are really dangerous. You mustn't go."
"Ha, you don't know me, but I am really a heavenly warrior, and nothing frightens me. If you want to live here in peace again, you must trust me and come along to help."
The dog wagged its tail with pleasure and said,
"All right, I'll come with you. But first, we must build a boat, because the demons burned all the ones the fishermen use."
Off they went to the woods. Momotaro was just about to chop down a tree when an angry chattering made him look up.
"Gotcha, gotcha, 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 gotcha."
A large monkey was sitting on a branch, staring angrily down.
"Go away, you dirty devil! This is my home!"
Momotaro stepped back and the dog started barking.
"I'm not a devil at all. My friend here and I are on our way to fight the demons of Ogre Island. But first, we have to build a boat."
"Oh, that's different. I'd like to fight those ogres. Let me go with you. I know a trick or two."
"Good. Have one of these. It'll give you extra strength."
Momotaro threw one of the dumplings up to the monkey, who then came down and joined them. Together they cut down another tree. But when it crashed to the ground, there was a sudden beating of wings and a loud screeching.
Quick, 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 quick!
It was a huge golden pheasant. The dog ran to catch it, and soon a fight began between the two animals.
Quick, 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 quick!
The pheasant fought gamely and fiercely, and the dog snapped and snarled. Momotaro ran up to separate them.
Please stop it immediately. We must all be friends and save our strength if we are going to win the battle against the ogres.
Against the ogres?
Echoed the pheasant.
But I thought you were ogres.
No, no,
said Momotaro, and explained to the bird what they intended to do.
Oh, I see. I hate them too. They're always coming and destroying our nests. Please let me join you.
Of course,
said Momotaro, and gave him a dumpling.
Eat this, and you will become as strong as an eagle.
The boat was soon ready, and they set off for the island. Momotaro steered, the monkey and the dog rowed, and the pheasant led the way by flying ahead. When they reached the island, they saw a huge castle towering above the beach. Momotaro stood thinking for a moment. He took off his headband, wiped his brow with it, and then said to the pheasant,
Right. You fly up into the castle and see what's going on.
Then he tied his headband on again tightly and prepared to attack. The pheasant flew over the castle wall and found the ogres in the middle of a feast. Immediately, he landed on their table and announced,
Ogres, your time has come. Momotaro is here with his army.
Momotaro? What's that? Sounds like something to eat,
said the chief of the ogres, and they all burst out laughing. With that, the pheasant began flying around in their faces, pecking as hard as he could. The ogres jumped up, upset the table, and in their confusion began attacking each other. When the monkey heard all the commotion, he quickly scrambled up the wall, jumped down inside, and unbolted the gate. In rushed Momotaro and the dog. The blue-faced chief of the ogres let out a great roar of anger, pulled out his sword and shouted,
How dare you come to our island uninvited and upset our party? I'll cut you all into little pieces and we'll make mincemeat of you. If you don't like that idea, get out while the going's good.
Momotaro stood his ground.
You big blue bully! Just you try to cut us up. I am Momotaro, and I know all about you evil beasts.
The ogre rushed at him. But Momotaro calmly drew his sword and with one swift thrust pierced the ogre's black heart. He fell to the ground with a thud. Encouraged by this, the dog, the monkey, and the pheasant attacked more fiercely. The dog scratching and snapping. The monkey squealing and shrieking. And the pheasant screeching and squawking. Momotaro's sword flashed, and heads of many colors rolled. In their fear, the remaining ogres, completely forgetting that ogres cannot swim, jumped into the sea And of course, they all drowned. Exhausted but triumphant, our four heroes went through the castle to see if any ogres were hiding from them. But all they found was a great pile of gold and silver, including all the treasure from the village temple. They loaded it all onto their boat, set fire to the evil castle, and rowed joyfully back to the fishing village. The villagers, who had been hiding in the woods, saw the smoke rising and rushed excitedly down to the shore. Imagine their surprise when they saw the little wooden boat full of treasure and manned by Momotaro and his animal friends. Momotaro gave all the treasures from the temple back to the priest and then presented the village headman with 1/5 of the ogre's loot. The villagers begged them all to stay, but Momotaro said,
"Thank you for your invitation, but I must get back to my dear old parents, for I know they will be very anxious."
Then he invited the animals to go home with him. The pheasant replied,
"Momotaro, it's been a great day, but I cannot come with you because my wife and chicks are waiting for me, and the family must be fed. Thank ye, and farewell."
Momotaro thanked him and gave him 1/5 of the treasure. The monkey said,
"Momotaro, much as I would love to come with you, I too have a family waiting. But thanks to you, I have learned the importance of friendship in overcoming evil. Thank you, and goodbye."
Momotaro shook him by the paw and gave him his share of the treasure. The dog said,
"Momotaro, this is my village, and I must stay here. Thanks to you, I have learned how to guard it properly. Thank you, and good luck."
Momotaro stroked his head and gave him his portion of the gold. Then he strode up the hill and headed for home. How delighted his parents were to see him again. Momotaro said to them,
"I told you I would return rich, and I have kept my promise."
He opened his dumpling bag and poured a pile of gold coins out onto the floor of the humble cottage. The old couple were amazed and embraced him lovingly. That night, they celebrated their son's return with a lovely meal. It included a huge plate of Momotaro's favorite juicy dumplings. And I wonder if you can guess what they had for dessert. Yes, you're right. Strawberry ice cream.